Hey guys, thanks for joining me today on the Investor Spotlight podcast. This is going to be a video that we're actually putting into the Tax, Legal, and Asset Protection Secrets for Real Estate Investors Facebook group, which is the Royal Legal Solutions Facebook group. Of course, I'm Scott Royal Smith, the owner of Royal Legal Solutions. I have the privilege of sitting with Mike Ayala today. He's a fellow GoBundance member. I know you guys have heard me talk about that group a ton, and that we actually shot a podcast today that was a ton of fun for his show that I'm hoping that he's going to plug right now after I turn over the mic to him. Mike, what do you think is going to be important for us as a community to know about you and your journey through real estate investing?
So first off, I appreciate you being on the show today. I'm really excited to drop that because the environment we're in right now, the stuff that you dropped today was gold. So we can talk about where they can find that later. But you know, as far as the real estate investing arena goes, I'm heavily focused in the manufactured housing space right now. We've got 39 communities in 13 different states, got a construction company, a property management company. I don't know how much detail you want to go into on all that, but that's kind of like the high level of what we're up to.
Yeah. So long story short, guys, is Mike is high level. He's been doing the stuff, building teams, building all different types of like the hub and the spoke of what it takes to be able to scale companies. So just want to put that in. So like, okay, that's your benchmark for like what types of questions, what types of things is Mike going to be able to help you with? I'm into that. So Mike, what are the types of, you know, the market's changed a lot, right? I mean, like things are evolving so quickly right now. How are you finding that you and your company are able to help people right now?
You know, so I've been saying this a lot lately, the fundamentals of affordable housing haven't really changed. In fact, I think the argument on the other side of this, I think it's going to increase. And so, you know, we're all in this together, and without going too far into my background, I actually lived in a 1976 single wide with five of us at one point in time. And so I've got a passion for the affordable housing space. And so, you know, I've really got two people that we can really help. There's the family that needs that affordable housing. That's one of our clients at Park Place Communities. But then on the other side of that, we have Four Peaks Capital Partners. And so we deal with accredited investors and work side by side, helping people achieve more financial literacy through teaching and also passive income through investing.
Yeah. Can you tell us a little bit more about that? Because I know a lot of people are, you know, have a ton of options about like, who do they want to be paying attention to when it talks about like, where do I place money? I know a lot of people are like, hey, I don't want money in markets and other things like that right now. I'm looking to place money inside of places where I'm going to have more stability than that. Can you give us some more background on that for people that are coming in to do the conversation with that kind of mindset?
Yeah, well, I think now more than ever, one of the things that I've talked about a lot, you've got different areas of real estate that you can invest in, obviously. And if you're not really wanting to invest hands-on, meaning I don't want to go out and buy a single wide family and manage that property. So many times people are like, I don't want to change toilets in the middle of the night. Well, you don't have to. You could hire a property manager, but at the same time, you can also come alongside and find an operator. And so I've been saying this for a while. I think more important than anything is the team that you invest with. And this is one of those periods of time where, you know, a lot of teams and a lot of operators are unfortunately not going to make it through this. And so it's the teams that adapt and adjust and improvise through this process. So I think the fundamentals of that are the same as well. Like really dig into the team that you're operating with. You know, what's their property management background? What's their construction background? What level of capital experience do they have managing? And so that's what I would really say is just vet the team. So many people pay attention to the deal, but I think the team behind the deal is just as important.
Awesome. And if when you're looking to vet a team, do you think that it's important to like, hey, like I need to go meet those people face to face, or is there good ways to like vet teams virtually?
Well, you know, we're all adapting and adjusting more to the virtual world. I'm a proponent of face to face. I have been for a long time, and we have a lot of investors that'll fly into our office and spend some time and actually meet the team. But this, you know, the other side of that, the majority of our investors have never actually met us, and so I, you know, phone calls are fine. And again, this day and age, we're kind of trapped right now with the COVID-19. But I think as long as you can build some kind of relationship, do your due diligence, dig into the relationship. I think relationship is key. You were talking about that this morning on the podcast. I think community relationship, I think we're coming back to that. And I think that's the key indicator that you should follow with investment is, you know, do you have a relationship with this operator?
That's awesome, man. So those are some really great ways, guys, that like Mike is going to be able to help you, is going to be able to help talking with you guys about how do you actually look at operators right now? How do you vet operators? How do you vet teams? How do you vet what good deals would look like? He's also going to have other opportunities for you to make investments into his company if that's something that you want to do, right? So the great thing about this, guys, and what's so important about this community that we're putting together is that this is your opportunity to be able to get access to really high-level people to have insights into how do high-level people operate? Because they actually operate differently than everybody else, right? They're looking for different things, right? And the reason why is because the people that are at higher levels of the game here, what they do is a lot of times what they're looking for is not necessarily like the really direct pieces of information, right? Like you look at a deal and you say, hey, like this looks actually good on like on paper, right? It's like, cool. Well, almost anybody can make a piece of paper look good. You know, it's really hard to look good. Your team. Like, how does that team function? Like, right? How good are the people on that team? How knowledgeable are they? How committed do you feel like they are? How connected do you feel like those team members are to one another? And that can tell you a lot more about like how good that deal actually is. And I think that's what Mike is underscoring for you guys. And those are the types of insights that connecting with Mike is going to be able to provide for you. And Mike, what's the name of your podcast?
It's called Investing for Freedom.
Yeah, and that was one of the things that I've seen with some of the great guests that Mike has had on the Investing for Freedom. I can say they're all great guests because I was a guest on it. But that's also a great place for you to learn more about Mike and how he's thinking things, how he's asking other people questions to be able to draw out their wisdom, just like you could turn around and ask Mike questions to draw out from some of his wisdom as well. So Mike, we just went over a bunch of ways that you can help other people that are there in the community. And what ways can the community help support you personally or to be able to support Investing for Freedom?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, listening and just sharing advice and communicating. I've got a Facebook community that we're launching called Investing for Freedom. So, you know, that's going to be a great area where we bring in a lot of experts. It's kind of, it's a different level of what you've put together here. But, you know, anybody that wants to join that community, come in there and just input, ask questions, just engage in the community. The more we can support each other, the better off we all are. And the one thing that I will say about your community, I know several people, just back to the team and the analysis, you were talking about the deal analysis. There's several people that you have in your community that I actually reach out to and I run my deals by them sometimes. So you've built a fabulous group of people. I know you had Hans Box. He's one of the guys that, you know, I reach out to when I want something analyzed or a stress test on a deal or a property, even if we're not investing together. So you've got some great people in this group and I really appreciate you for that. So yeah, I mean, back to the question, listen to the podcast. If you come across any mobile home park deals or anybody looking to sell, you know, we'll pay a pretty good finder's fee if you find an off-market deal. So just kicking deals our way, whatever I can do to help you guys, just reach out. I think the more we can just get into relationship and community, the better off we're all going to be.
Yeah, 100%, guys. You can't have too much community at a time like this, right? Because each different community is going to be a little bit different. I like what values they have, what are the things that they're going to think is important from the leadership of those communities. And the more communities you're involved with, the more different angles you're going to be able to look at the same problem. And it's actually the more angles you can look at the same problem, which is the true creativity to be able to get you to the solution set that's going to be able to be the best for you personally. So we're talking about these different communities. We're not competing in communities because I'm saying join all the communities, pay attention to them, connect with as many people as you can, because that is the way to navigate yourself into the better solution, into how do you come out of COVID stronger than you went into it, is going to be doing that. So Mike is in the good fight, just like we are here at Royal Legal Solutions and part of this community, being able to pull it together. So we're going to post this video into the Facebook group. So that's the Tax Asset Protection and Legal Secrets for Real Estate Investors Facebook group. That is the Facebook group for Royal Legal Solutions. Drop some comments into here. I'm going to make sure that Mike gets those comments so be able to answer any of the questions that you guys have, any places that you might find deals that Mike might want to look at. Just anything that's in that context, it's a great place to do it, is to drop that in the comment. But Mike, for anybody else that's listening to the podcast, maybe they're on Facebook, what's the best way for them to connect with you and to be able to, you know, connect into your communities and learn more from you?
Yeah, so I have a website. It's www.investingforfreedom.co. So that's probably the best place. From there, you can get connected with our asset management company, Four Peaks Capital Partners. We can touch base with Park Place Communities from there. So that's the main place to find us.
That's awesome. Well, thanks, Mike, so much for coming on to the Investor Spotlight Podcast. Everybody, stay tuned. Reach out to Mike. Drop some comments here on the video. Check out the Investing for Freedom Podcast. It's a great show.
Appreciate you.